Uber technology CEO Travis Kalanick is vowing to, quote, grow up, unquote. The Wall Street Journal's Greg Bensinger reports that Kalanick says he's going to seek leadership advice after a run of troubling news involving the company, capped Tuesday by the revelation of an online video showing Kalanick lashing out at an Uber driver who asked him questions about the company's fares.
We started with $20.
You know what?
How much is the mile now? $2.75?
You know what?
What?
Some people don't like to take responsibility for
their shit.
They blame everything in their life on somebody else.
But why are you sending an email for Town Car?
Good luck.
Good luck to you too, but I know you don't gonna go far.
Following the video's release, Kalanick wrote a note to employees saying he's ashamed of the behavior captured by the driver's dashboard camera. Quote, this is the first time I've been willing to admit that I need leadership help and I intend to get it, he said. An Uber spokesman declined to comment. Ride-hailing service Uber was dreamed up in 2008 when its founders Travis Kalanick and Garrett Camp couldn't get a cab on a snowy night. Their idea, tap a button and get a ride, is now a reality, having given birth to Uber and the growing slate of competing companies that are transforming the traditional ride service model. But now Uber, which became a formal entity in 2009, looks to be going through some sort of midlife crisis. In recent months, Uber's been hit with a firestorm of issues, including accusations of permissiveness about sexism and sexual harassment in the workplace. Uber has hired former U.S. Attorney General Eric Holder to lead an internal investigation into the claims by a former female employee. Meantime, Google parent Alphabet sued Uber, alleging that some of the startup's employees stole self-driving vehicle intellectual property. And Uber has also faced customer retaliation for appearing to undermine taxi drivers in New York, leading some to start a Delete Uber movement, and also resulting in Kalanick stepping down from a business advisory group to President Trump. With a valuation from investors of $68 billion, Kalanick has helped build Uber into the most highly valued private startup in the world. That said, his concession of needing help is in line with a broader Silicon Valley tradition where more seasoned executives are brought in to help smooth out rougher edges of startups' founders. That becomes especially important when such companies choose to go public and must win over potential investors.